Hello guys, welcome to Amit Things. In this video, we will see how we can easily install the current Java version, that is Java 19. With that, we will also run a sample Java program. Let's see. At first, go to the web browser. I am using Chrome. You can use any browser. On Google, type Oracle Java. Press enter. On pressing enter, the official website is visible, oracle.com/java. Click on it. On clicking, we have reached the official website. Now on the top right, you can see download Java. Click on it to download. Go below. When you'll reach below, you can see Java 19 is available now. Okay, I'll go below again, and here it is Java 19 JDK. And go to Windows because you want for Windows 10. And herein we will go for the x64 installer, that is the exe file. Click on it to download. This also includes the JRE, so you don't need to install JRE separately. You just need to install JDK 19 for Java. Click on it to download. Download started, it's only 159 MB. Let's wait for few seconds. So guys, we have successfully downloaded it. Double click on to install. Minimize this. So guys, the installation setup is visible. Click on next. Here in Java path is visible. Java will get installed here, JDK 19. If you want to change the location, you can click on change, but this is fine. Click on next. So guys, we have successfully installed JDK 19. Click on close. Now let us see wherein we installed it. It was under C drive, if you remember, program files, Java, and here it is JDK 19 path. Copy this path. Okay, minimize. Go to start, type environment variables. Click on the following first one, that is edit the system environment variables. Click on it, open. Now under advanced tab, click on environment variables. Herein you can see system variables, click on new. Herein type java underscore home and paste the same path. Which path? Which we just saw. Okay, that's it. Click on OK. Now go below. Double click on path here. Click on new. And herein you need to set the path. Which path? Herein click bin and set the bin path. Now right click and copy it, minimize, and click new. Just paste the same path. Okay, now we have two paths. We have set two paths. Okay, now the third path, for that go to here, go to C drive, program files, common files. Here it is common files, Oracle, Java, and Java path. Right click and copy this. Minimize. Click on new. Right click the same path. Click on OK. OK. And the last OK. Now when you'll go to start and type environment variables again. Here it is, system environment variables. Click on open. Now you can see all these paths are visible. You can see Java underscore home path, the first path we set, and under path, when you will double click, you can see two paths are visible, the bin path and the Oracle Java path. That's it. We successfully added the path. Now go to start, type cmd, click on open to open the command prompt. So we have successfully installed. Now you will verify, type java space hyphen hyphen version and press enter. Here it is, we successfully installed Java 19. Check for compiler also, java c space hyphen hyphen version and press enter. Here it is Java 19. So we successfully installed it. Now guys, what we will do, we will run our first program, Java program. After installing it, for that let's say I'll go to D drive, and herein I'll create, right click new, create a new text document. I'll name it studiopedia, and I'll just change the path from txt to java, okay, and I'll just keep the cursor here, and it will ask you, do you want to change the file name extension? I'll click on yes. Now our txt file is a java file. Herein you can see java source file. If you're unable to find this option, you are unable to rename it, just go to view and select this file name extensions. When selecting it, you'll be seeing the file name extension, and you can easily rename it like this. Now guys, open this with the notepad or notepad plus plus like this, or you can edit with notepad plus plus. Now let us type the code, sample code. Public is an access modifier, class is the keyword, and the name. Remember, the name of the class should be equivalent to the name of the file, that is studiopedia. Okay, now that's it. Just mention public static void main. Now let us print something, system.out.println. First Java program. Okay, now let us understand this. Public is an access modifier. Static allows the main function to be called without the need to instantiate a particular instance. Okay, without creating any object, we can call it using static. Void is a return type. Main, this function is called whenever a Java application begins. Okay, string argument, I told you this is basically a parameter arg, which is an array of instances of the class string. This will allow you to receive any command line argument. System is a predefined class, out is an output stream, and println is a method to display the string. Okay, that's it. Go to file, click on save. We have created it. It's in a D drive. Go to the command prompt. Since we are in C drive, I'll just type D colon and we'll reach the D drive. Herein directly our file is visible, so type java C. That is, first we will compile and then we will run in Java. Mention the name of the file, studiopedia.java, and press enter. Let's see if there is an error. Yes, we forgot the semicolon, no problem. Type semicolon and click on save, minimize. Type the command again, press enter. There should be no error. Here it is. Now type java studiopedia and press enter. Before pressing enter, you can see now we have our studiopedia.class file. So class file generated, the entire JVM process is here. So the class file is now generated. We successfully compiled it. Now we will run it. And after running, here it is. First Java program, we successfully printed it. Here it is. First Java program, we successfully printed it. So guys, in this video, we saw how we can successfully download and install the current Java version, Java 19. We also saw how we can run our first program. Thank you for watching the video.